suppose I've got a depth scene here, and I'd like to match it to some model or some previously observed depth scene. How might I do that? Well, what I need to do is I need to find some patches, some locations on my object, and match them to some locations on my object. And, you know, it should be somewhat invariant to how I look at it, right? So I'm looking over here, looking over there, I want to find the same thing. The object might be rotated. Things might... We've seen this movie before. Remember we were matching pictures? We had two pictures that were rotated, translated, scaled, and we wanted to align them. Do you remember SIFT? SIFT was a way of saying, and Harris points, remember they were Harris Stevens points and nobody ever remembered Stevens. We had ways of finding points and then generating a descriptor, and that descriptor had to be sort of discriminative and yet robust. That is, we wanted them to be relatively unique but robust, so that when we found a description here and we matched it with the description there, it would most likely be the right one. And then we improved that. We used ransack in order to find the right sets of matches. Well, we can do exactly the same thing with depth. You know, what's drawn here is that I've got this interest point and I've got this sort of neighborhood of these 5 points around it, or I might look at a volume of these. And what I'm going to do is I might find the relationship between these points and, say, the little local normals associated with the point or something to do about the geometry. The idea is whatever it is that I'm measuring is not a function of how I looked at the points. So, in fact, the way we often do these is we typically will build a, we'll take these points and we'll build a description and we'll put them into a histogram. Okay, so maybe we just quantize these different orientations into, you know, 5 different levels. So we have, you know, 5-level thing, and then we might have distances. So, in fact, one example, they used a 5 by 5 by 5 histogram that gave you 125 different values. Okay, remember in SIFT, I think we had 128 different values. So here we have 125 different values. And then for every patch, we compute these and we can compare them against the patches in our model, find the putative matches, and then do something like ransack to do the matching. There's a version called the fast point feature histogram, which is a way of doing this in 3D. And again, I think is probably implemented directly in the point cloud library. So, there are a couple of places where the point cloud library, I already pointed you at pointclouds.org. For many of you in the robotics universe, there's something called ROS, the Robot Operating System, originally out of Willow Garage, and then it's Robotics Software Open Foundation. It's got all those letters in it. It's an open source ongoing development system for doing robotics. And the point cloud library, and by the way, OpenCV, computer vision library, are all part of that universe. And that's really helped make it easy for people to do that development. And there are drivers, by the way, in that for using the Kinect or PrimeSense sensors as well, so you can go get your point clouds that way. So here's a picture that I showed you before from pointclouds.org. And in fact, here it says ransack cylinder segmentation. So basically, they ransack to find the different planes and to also find these different cylinders. You know how to do that already, so you could do this. And it basically gives you a direct interpretation of the geometry.